hasn't worked in the second set. She's going to have to pump up the aggression level a little bit and declare herself more.
In this set, Serena jumped out to a 4-love lead. Capriati broke in the first two service games of the set and serves at 1-5.
Capriati hopes that Serena comes on cold as she did in the first set of this women's quarterfinal.
Rain delay about 45 minutes. And fans enjoying a much lighter sky, sun trying to break through. At second serve at 80 miles an hour.
Three errors from Serena Williams when Capriati signed on with Heinz Gunthart. Of course, we all asked Jennifer, well, what's he doing for your serve? Because this has been her biggest liability in recent years. And she said, oh, no, he says it's okay. But in fact, he has been trying to get her to cover the ball more, to give it more spin, give it more safety. The safest thing she could do is to keep that first serve percentage high. As you can see, she's getting punished on those second ones.
Another broken string? No, guess not. And Serena, forgetting the score, understandably with the rain delay, will serve for one set all when we come back.
People claim to have a method,
a surefire approach.
I don't know anyone who stumbled
into wealth.
I make money the
same way my clients do.
I work for it.
Work hard.
A method?
A system?
A pattern? I get up every morning at 4:30.
When I look across the desk
at my clients,
I see a little bit of myself in them.
I think they see the same in me.
Smith Barney.
This is who we are.
This is how we earn it.
Have you got your Goodyears? Stop in now while all Goodyear tires are on sale. Buy four selected Goodyear tires and get up to a $60 rebate. Keep your car in step. Get your Goodyears today.
Scent is the strongest sense tied to memory. How will you be remembered? Introducing new Red Zone Invisible Solid. It's the longest lasting invisible solid from Old Spice, so you smell great all day and all night. New Red Zone Invisible Solid in 4 cents. Stay in the zone.
The famed River Seine. We're back in Paris, the city of light. And it has been all of that until the last 2 days when it has become a gray French capital. Rain today from morning through midday, and hopefully it's had its say for the afternoon as we continue here in the second set. Serena Williams up at double break. Serves for one set all at 5-2. New balls. Haven't been many stirring rallies, just a couple. It's just been who's going to make the mistake first.
Capriati can't offer up this kind of stuff. Again, she's got to get more aggressive. shots that Serena was missing all over the first set. She's not missing as much now. Capriati's got to recognize that and up her own aggression.
And there's the set. At 6-2, they'll play a third set for the French Open semifinals.
Shave your beard.
2-0, and Serena with an excellent record. Look at that, almost 70% when going a third set. With a couple long forehands. Capriati 30 love. Staring down at the baseline as if she got a bad bounce. Capriati punished again on the second serve as Serena drills that return.
Tompkins. Clay court tennis at its best. Boy, oh boy.
Oh, man. Combination of two weather delays, heavy balls, the court pretty thick. And another forehand error, and Capriati has the opening game of the final set.
Court Philippe Chatrier just about packed for this third set. And in anticipation of the Amélie Mauresmo quarterfinal against Elena Dementieva that follows this one. So funny, isn't it, to think that this is a warm-up match for the French? Another error.
Mauresmo will meet Elena Dementieva, against whom she has a 5-1 record.
That's a nice serve from Serena. Kicked off nicely, and Serena did a much better job in that second set serving than she did in the first. Lost only 6 points on her serve to make this go 3. Just looks better. She looks more alert. She's moving better. Unfortunately for her, her strokes continue to betray her.
Second double fault.
This kind of tennis, if you're going to play the kind of tennis that these two play, that so many of the top women play, you know, big, physical, aggressive tennis, you've got to be fit, first and foremost, and then you've got to stay calm so you can control all this power. And these two can bring out the nerves in each other.
109 miles an hour, actually rounded off. Second double fault in this game.
That's a big relief for Serena. She still hasn't found her range since they've come back on the court. She served two double faults and still held. This is what happens when you put these two out there. So psychological and emotional with these two. Capriati will try to work over the Serena Williams forehand side.
5-0.
Which is the way to go. Her backhand is more solid. Technically.
That
skips off the line.
Well, that looked as if it was going to be long, didn't it? But it fell right on the line for 30 love.
Capriati says that when she beat Serena a couple of weeks ago in the Italian Open, she mixed up her game well. She served well, and she didn't give Serena the same look. Don't want to get Serena grooved. And here she is coming to net again. That's how she beat her.
Two consecutive points at the net. Let's see if she continues to attack. She holds it love, 2-1 on serve, final set.
Mr. Thompson, after hearing the evidence and listening to your testimony, this committee finds you guilty of...
In 1990.
It's her first ever French Open. Dick, she got her way to the semis. It was half a lifetime ago for Jennifer. Selis went on to win that. Selis's parents watching this, her first ever. And of course, it was a dazzling Grand Slam tournament debut for the kid. But no one to me was like Selis on clay. Stefano and Denise Capriati have been in this position before. This is match point for Selis, and she takes it, goes on to win the French that year. And now, half a lifetime later, Jennifer Capriati is the oldest woman left in the draw.
It's a stunning period of time. Selis not here. Of course, she won the three consecutive French titles. Youngest to ever make it to the semis of a major at 14.
Then, you know, a lot of us thought, well, she was only a couple of years away from winning her first major. And of course, that only happened a couple of years ago. Two Australian Opens, one French championship. Dick, I remember the years where Monica Seles and Steffi Graf were playing their clay court tennis. I'm telling you, I think either one of those would beat anybody these days. Those two, they played a 1992 final that I still think is the greatest match I've ever seen. Went the distance, Seles finally deciding it. I mean, they hit as hard as possible, and they had a handful of errors a set between them. It was, talk about controlled aggression. Nicely found. A mishit volley gave Capriati the chance to line up for that pass. Just hit that volley thin, did Serena.
number four, and to 30 all. First break point here, the final set. Capriati with a chance for the lead. She got away with a couple double faults her last service game. Can she again? And raises that left knee. That was the knee kept her out for 8 months with surgery. Oh my! How did that ball clear the net?
40.
Not by much. Kind of lunged at it a little bit, which helped her actually in getting that angle.
Big save at break point. But she's disgusted with her serve here in this third set. That went halfway down the net. And another break point for Capriati.
This is a tribute to the great fighting heart of Serena Williams. She tends to be able to find a way, but again, I rush to add that in the last 2 years, her only five losses have come on this surface.
In this run of 45-1, the loss to Anna Ardan last year in the semis.
Going after the forehand again.
Avantage, Mademoiselle Capriati.
Break point number three.
Merci.
And another second serve. Capriati has the lead, 3-1. Oh, that was an ugly service game for Serena Williams. Couple of double faults. And now 9 unforced errors to 3 here in this set. And she started off poorly in losing that opening set, 19 unforced.
In that last game, Capriati only hit one winner. Serena gave her that game. She had 5 unforced.
Little anger in that forehand.
0-15.
Jean-Paul Belmondo, same French actor. Been here many years.
Oh man, she missed that.
Had a big hole.
This is, oh boy. Have kids. That's what my parents always say to me.
Right back with three chances for the breakback. Off the baseline and terrible bounce.
15-40.
But two more break chances for Serena. Get back on serve.
Mademoiselle Williams.
Who wants it? 3-2, back on serve.
Capriati mène 3-2.
Teatro Greco, Taormina, Sicily.
Pressed on that one too much.
Actually see a patch of blue sky. That's good news. Out to the west. So much success for this woman. One is likely to overlook the fact she's only 22. With a
count bombs.
Another error from Serena Williams' forehand side.
Seventeen winners, 38 unforced errors total. But still anyone's match here. We're in the third, 2-3. And Serena Williams a point away from 3-all.
Oh boy, Capriati has really backed off. A very timid return there that finds the net. Boy, remember that she had that real snappy game to start, you know, early in the third, coming to net a couple of times, imposing herself on this match?
See if she remembers that. Serena, owner of all four. Grand Slam singles titles, and with her sister shares all four doubles in major play.
10-0.
Total of 24 titles at age 22. Hall of Fame stuff at such a young age.
Oh.
Nicely done. We haven't seen that play.
Pretty neutral rally. And Capriati decides to carve under that one for the winner. Serena barely could make a move to it.
Deeper into this final set. 4-3 on serve.
Hey, Herman.
At one time, it was a medieval fortress, a palace of the kings of France, and for the last two centuries, one of the world's great museums, the Louvre, here in Paris. See the Mona Lisa, Venus de Milo, winged victory. How about the victory? Is it on the wing? Let's go down to Mal.
Well, Dick, I'm here with Denise Capriati. Denise, let me ask you, during all of these rain delays, what advice did you have for Jennifer back in the locker room?
Well, I didn't really see her in the locker room. She just came up to, you know, say she was going out, and I just said, do the best that you can, and I love you.
Based on what you've seen here in this third set, she was up a break, she lost the break. How do you think she's looking right now?
She's playing as best as she can. I mean, both of them are kind of look like they're having some problems, you know, but she's moving and as much as she can.
You know, certainly this is a big match for her, having recently beaten Serena. How did she feel going into this match, last night or even this morning?
She felt, you know, good about it, but, you know, she's got a sore leg, and so, you know, she didn't know how she was going to feel today, but, you know, she's giving it all she has.
Is her leg affecting her at all, from as far as you can tell from right now?
Maybe she's a little hesitant in her moving, you know. It looks that way to me, but she said she was fine, so.
Denise, thanks very much, and try not to be so nervous.
Thanks, Mal.
Easy enough for you to say, Mal. Well measured on that overhead. Good challenge from Capriati.
30-0.
A high-kicking second serve that Capriati timed beautifully and decided to come in behind it to great effect.
Wiping away some of the fresh brick off her knee as she went all the way to the surface to try to get that ball over the net.
That's exactly right. Serena telling herself, okay,
please.
First serve, please. I tell you, she's struggling today, but I so admire the way she fights. Right now, she's fighting herself. I'm not sure if she's winning or losing. It's out.
And with it, Capriati gets a break point. Here at a critical juncture at 3-4.
Thank you.
this. Disheartening.
And a second serve got her in trouble, and Capriati pounces on that short ball and takes a 5-3 lead and serve for the semifinals.
Got what she wanted, Capriati, and took a nice big cut at the ball and followed it in.
Well, Capriati took the lead earlier in this final set, only to be broken back at love. Check that, at 15. Three more points, Papa says. Now it's Serena with a chance to take a full swing at a second serve. Called it, Mary, right from the start. The second serve is going to be so important. You've got to get first serves in, and neither woman has been able to be consistent in that regard. By Serena, trying to will the ball over. But is that symptomatic? She's 1 point away from sliding out of this championship. Saying it's long, and the chair umpire agrees. The ball was good, but the lines person called it out.
Wait, the point?
It was good. Shot spot confirms.
The ball was good and it was a winning shot. Why are they replaying the point?
Mesdames et messieurs, le juge de ligne a annoncé la balle faute et c'est corrigé. On rejoue le point.
The linesman called it out. We have to replay this point. Capriati understands.
S'il vous plaît.
That is horrible bad luck.
How is it that the ball finds that kind of situation at such a critical point? Match point. She's done it anyway. Capriati. advances to the semifinals 6-3 in the final set.
These fans, so many of them, remember when she was the youngest woman in the draw. Now she's the oldest. And she was able to battle through a very tough match. Gave it a little Agassi there.
And we'll meet either Serena's sister Venus or Anastasia Mesquina in the semifinals. Quick exit by Serena Williams. The match ending on her 45th unforced error. But Capriati building off the emotions of winning in Rome after an 8-game losing streak against Serena Williams.
It wasn't a great match, Dick. I mean, it really was not a great match. It was well fought, obviously, but the hell of it is that Capriati played not to lose and won.
And earns the chance to battle in the semifinals with an opportunity to win her second French Open championship. Jennifer Capriati is through to the final four, 6-3, 2-6, 6-3 over Serena Williams. A match laden with errors and difficulty on first serves. And Serena Williams finally with the ultimate mistake, the forehand into the bottom of the net, and a disappointing dismissal for the 2002 champion. But the woman who won in 2001 continues as part of the story at Roland Garros 2004.
Choice Hotels invites you to really see the world. It's our Wake Up a Winner sweepstakes, where you can win a dream vacation.
You always can use a little luck when you're trying to win a big event. Could help.